wash my soul in the ocean, in the tears of God, I let it go.
Hello, my fellow Aries warriors. From July 2020, you are called to the battle. Whether you are Aries rising, sun, or moon, epochal times are coming for us, Aries. It is going to get so interesting. The second part of the year 2020 becomes the most dynamic and active for us. We are going to ride the roller coaster, but I expect that July and part of August will be the part of the roller coaster ride that goes up. And then from the end of August, September, we're starting the real, you know, up and down ride. So we'll play a really important role for the next 6 months, starting with July 2020 as Aries. Our life will be transformed on a very deep level, externally, internally. And let's see what July is going to hold for us. The most important thing that's going to happen is that Mars, the planet that rules us, is going to enter its own sign, Aries. And it's going to stay there for 6 months. And Mars has not been that close to the Earth in something like 40 years. So Mars is so powerful, which means that us Aries are going to be given a lot of strength, a lot of power. Why are we given that? Because we're going to have a battle to fight. It's going to be a battle of a lifetime. And of course, we can come out really victorious at the end, depends. But now we're called to be the warriors, the generals that we are, the the trailblazers, and almost like leaders in our environment, whether on a personal or collective level for the next 6 months. This is what we're going to be called for, especially with a peak in September, October, and November, but it's starting already from July, when the moment Mars enters our sign. And you're going to start getting clues from July, what it is that you're meant to do for the next 6 months. And you're going to start seeing situations forming in your life, which directly impact you. It's in our sign, after all, which will call you to arm up, which will call you to almost like muster all your resources, to gather all your strength for an adventure of a lifetime. Let's call it this way. Let's not call it a challenge of a lifetime, because once it is achieved, we're going to be on another level as Aries. We're going to, by the end of the year 2020, we're going to be taken to another level, much higher, a different way of manifesting. We'll have achieved some feat of willpower. Mars rules the willpower in the horoscope, our willpower. So by the end of this period, starting with July till the end of the year, we're going to be taken to the next level. We'll achieve something that we probably never had the strength before in our lifetimes, something that we never had the courage to do before, something that we never even had the energy and mobilization. Mars will mobilize us like an army indeed. Mars will, especially maybe the previous couple of months, Aries might have felt a bit tired, a bit unmotivated, a bit distracted, because our planet Mars was in Pisces, which is kind of swimming with the fishes, like Dory, keep on swimming, you know. But now when it enters Aries, we get focused, we get given from the universe such a push, such a tremendous a force behind us, because we are called to do something big and great, and we'll initiate it because it's in our sign. It's not something that will depend on others. It will be something that is your own initiative, that you're not going to be receiving help from anyone else. You're the general, you're the king, you're the leader in that endeavor that you're starting. It's some powerful initiative that requires, and the willpower, if you haven't had willpower for something till now, this is going to change. You'll be given such a boost of willpower. Gradually, you'll start seeing it building up from July. And when Mars goes retrograde, that's when the real push is September, October, November. But we'll talk about that in the September, October, November videos. But for now, I'm just telling you, prepare. You'll be maybe rest a bit more till the start of July, because after that, there is no escaping. There is no, you'll be at the front of the battlefield. You'll be the one with the bayonet and going and charging, and everyone around you, if you're Aries, will be relying on you to break through, you know, and to start that battle. And it's not necessarily a battle. As I said, it can be a big event that you activate, that you initiate, that requires a lot of your energy, being burning the midnight oil, almost like staying, you know, and very fast and very short deadlines that you have to be under the pressure, you know, and the pressure will increase more and more as the months grow. But, you know, I think Aries will feel more alive than they've ever been, because this is what we're born for, guys. We as Aries, we are born to take up the arms. We're born to initiate and to blaze trails that no one has walked before, especially through jungles, and that are so difficult to go through. And I'm talking here figuratively, you know. I'm talking figuratively that you're going to have to make a path and blaze a trail through some really kind of dense forest where no one has dared go before you, where you personally have not dared go before. You'll be given the strength and the machete to chop through that. You just should not give up. And when things get too intense at moments, you know, quick break and back on the trail again, back on the road again. So, but energy will increase. Your motivation will increase so much. Your ambition will increase so much. You, as I'm telling you, we're gonna do some kind of feat of achievement in the next 6 months. Very hectic, very busy, starting already from July. And especially July will feel the early born areas, those born around March, you know, the March born areas, if your sun is there, and if your ascendant or moon is there, the first 10 degrees or something like that of Aries. But still, for every Aries, this is a time when you're coming back from the shadows, when you're becoming visible again. And by the way, I'm doing my first webinar as an Aries in 2 years, solo webinar. I haven't done personal webinars in 2 years. This one is going to be probably 200-300 people, so take your seat. And I'm going to give you with it 6 months of free transits, and it's going to be so you can see all your transits till the end of the year, and it's going to be on how Mars in Aries is going to influence you. If anyone takes this webinar, this is you, Aries, because this is Aries will feel this influence the most. It's only $39. You get transits for $15, that are for free for you, and how Mars will personally affect you. We're going to speak about each one of you, how Mars will personally affect you. So join it. Check out the link below and join me at that webinar. It's going to be like I'm doing your personal horoscope, basically. But yeah, so interesting times ahead, initiative. Just be careful with Mars in your sign. For the next 6 months, you'll be much more prone for any kind of, you'll be much more prone to have some kind of accidents, possibility of burns, cuts, arguments and fights. That's the lower and negative side of Mars, to be much more impetuous, even sometimes destructive in your rush to achieve things, or even a bit insensitive, but that's what we are called to do. All right, and then the next important thing that's happening, there is an eclipse that is happening, another eclipse. This year is relentless, guys, but that's how we like it. We're Aries, we like go, 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 change, change, change. And this is the year we're all changing. There is no turning around, you know. And it's very cardinal month, July, because there will also be, most of the planets are moving into cardinal sign. Cardinals are the signs that activate the most important areas of our lives. And action, action, movement, movement. So July is like a threshold for you, where the card starts turning, where the card starts moving, where the wheel of fortune starts moving for you. So the most important activity, as I said, it starts with Mars. But the other thing is, there is an eclipse happening in Capricorn in your 10th house. It's the last eclipse in your 10th house. And it's a lunar eclipse, which is active for about 6 months. So July, again, from the very beginning, this eclipse happens. And Saturn is coming back there. If you can see, Saturn is, it was in Aquarius for 3 months. It's coming back to Capricorn. So you have to complete the activities in regards to your career, which you, it's not new projects that are coming in career. It's something that you haven't completed, that you have to put structure and organize better, to redesign, to reorganize your career. And the last time Saturn dips into your 10th house, it's only for 6 months now, till the end of the year from July, it becomes relentless because it's the last, it's like a teacher that really believes in you, but it's very tough on you. And it has the last 6 months with you in regards to your career in particular, and in regards to your 10th house's social status. So it really wants, and Saturn is the planet like the death with the scythe. It wants to cut off the unnecessary and complicated things from there. Anything that is a blockage for you to be removed from your career, to be completed, to be perfected, to be put in order. This is what Saturn requires, and it is hard work. So a lot of focus again in your career, especially because there is an eclipse there as well, the start of July. It's eclipse, full moon eclipse. So it's telling you it's with the south node, which means to complete something, to end something. But it's active for 6 months. And while Saturn is also there in your 10th house, it says the next 6 months, guys, starting from July, you are completing something in regards to your career. You are maybe perfecting it, maybe, you know, removing the obstacles and working to resolve some complexity there, to simplify it, to make it more, to streamline your career. Maybe some of you will re-examine their career and say, is this the right direction? And you'll be very serious about it. This is Saturn. And some of you might be ending a career. Some of you might be ending a very important project that you have to complete. Some might be even able to end it by July, by the end of July. But for many, it might take a few months. But you're coming back to that project and you're working really hard on it. Or for some of you, it can mean like a job or work opportunity from the past is coming. In some way, you know, or if there is a problem with the father figure, authority figure, or an institution, you might have to be working with those for the next few months, starting from July, to really do it meticulously by the book, by the rule, because that's what Saturn in the 10th house is. The authority figures require you to be very straightforward, buttoned up, jacketed up in regards to your attitude and behaviors towards responsibility, duty, world responsibility, institutions, your career. But again, you can achieve great feats by the end of this year in regards to a career. Something that will put you on the map like you've never been before. Something that will really restructure your social status and bring you up there in regards to your career. You know, even given more responsibilities and duties. And of course, that will be hard while you have to deal with so many responsibilities and duties and to complete them and to end them. But that is, you know, the result will be three times more lasting. And of course, Jupiter is there, Pluto is there. But there is this tension in July that's happening for you. A lot of planets in Capricorn, which is your 10th house of career. So a lot of focus on a career, but also a lot of planets in your fourth house. With the sun here, I'm going to show you here. I can't find where the sun is. The children have put it somewhere, but the sun, moon, Mercury, it's in your fourth house. And they're part of the eclipse, so, and they stay there in your fourth house till the end, till the 20th of July. So there is this push and pull opposition between responsibility with your career, that you're coming back, that you really have to go hard on them, to restructure social status, to work with some institutions, to kind of resolve problems with authority figures or institutions. And at the same time, your home and family is really calling your attention. And Mercury has been retrograde and is retrograde till the 12th of July in your fourth house, which means that family matters get complicated till the middle of July. They start untangling after the middle of July. So, for example, it might be that you're having some verbal confrontation with family members, though some problems from the past with regards to family, extended family, are escalating in the place where you're living with flatmates, teammates. And when Mercury turns direct from the middle of the month, you're able to start resolving those problems. You're able to start seeing the results of important conversations that you led with those people and to sort them out in some way, hopefully. But also fourth house rules, for example, property and houses. So if you've been working hard on some project with property, with home, if you're trying to buy and sell, maybe if things were a bit delayed or complicated or just not budging, while Mercury was retrograde, though you were researching them, when it starts moving direct from the middle of the month, all such things will start resolving themselves and moving forward. So you might be able to relocate, to find a property, to sell a property then, to sign a contract, to move to a different place or whatever. It can indicate, wow, till the middle of the month, that you are reconnecting with family, that a lot of the times family requires your attention, family members you haven't seen from, you hear from, you connect till the middle of the month, you know, while Mercury is retrograde. And fourth house is also to acquire citizenship. If you're struggling, if you're trying to arrange some documents for citizenship or whatever, by the time Mercury starts moving direct from the middle of the month, these things will start moving forward. You will be able to receive it or to solve such a problem related to citizenship or other documents like diplomas as well, and documents like certificates. Certificates, whether for driving or whatever, it's the fourth house. So if you've had some delays in regards to those till the middle of the month and you have to maybe supply extra documents or, you know, the posts were delayed, whatever, then you'll be able to straighten them out by the start, by the middle of the month. They'll start moving forward. But it's like the family and personal life, there is a push and pull and very needed compromise to be found before between the needs of your family and the needs of your worldly responsibilities and career. So you'll be kind of torn between both of them. But also it means that you can achieve great steps forward. And dynamic changes, because it's cardinal signs, dynamic changes of circumstances related to your career and circumstances related to your home and personal life in July. But important events are happening there. And you're in the middle of it with Mars, you know, making the square aspects to all those planets. So you're required to act, move, you know, don't slouch, don't be. It's all on you guys. And at the end, there is around the 20th of July, there is a new moon in Cancer, but this time is not with eclipses. The first time there is a new moon in Cancer for the last 2 years, which doesn't have an eclipse for you. So it's like a new clean slate for your personal situation at home. And you probably see it over the month of August developing. So maybe finding a new place, maybe new beginning for your family. Maybe the difficult things around family have cleared up and you're given a second chance. And last, let's say something good. Oh, by the way, talking about eclipses, Victor is making a 12-week course that's starting in July. You can pay it in twice. It's only $300, but it's 3 or 4 months long, about the moon, everything about the moon, how to use eclipses, how to interpret eclipses in the personal chart, how to predict with the moon and eclipses, moon in houses and planets. So check out that webinar again as well. It's fascinating. You don't need to know even any astrology. It's like foundational courses. Just like with my webinar, Mars in Aries, you don't need to know any astrology. I have done it in such a way that everyone will understand it to see how the next month will be for you, especially Aries. And then Venus is going to be in your third house the whole July, moving forward, visible. So good things can come to you from this third house. So pleasant communications with people. When it comes to working in a group environment, agreement or with colleagues and teammates, agreement, cooperation, positive and ease and help with projects connected to commercial activities, administrative activities, sorting out documents, even some very pleasant journeys and trips here. Venus is in your third house. Some very pleasant journeys, short trips with maybe with loved ones, some romantic getaways with the partner, or even possibility for some romance online or romance with someone from your immediate environment, pleasant conversations with people. If you're in media or marketing, very well accepted campaigns in regards to that. So something good to look forward to. And also learning with pleasure. Reading with pleasure. That's your getaway in this really hectic month for your Aries, the third houses, you know, to read, to study. You'll be getting your pleasant kick out and release from activities of reading, communicating, exchanging ideas with others. And maybe the Facebook and social media, that will be your release somehow. Thank you so much. Do join me. You can check your transits for free on the transit calendar. There is a video that follows advertising it. It's used by 40,000 people. There is no such in the world anywhere else that is for free. And it's way more personal than than those monthly horoscopes. And way more personal. The transit, you'll see your transits that no one else in the world has the same like you. I love you.